If you have assertions in your code, not only can you detect errors much more easily, but you can also test your code much more thoroughly. In particular, you can separate two things. A test consists of two parts. First, we need to generate an execution, and second, we need to check the outcome. With assertions in your code, checking the results is already done, so you can focus on generating the tests. Let me illustrate this with a very, very simple example. The idea is that we're going to take a square root function with assertions integrated and just use random testing to test it. Here's a very, very simple implementation of our square root function. We simply invoke the built-in Python square root function from the math module, and we have set up appropriate assertions to check for the precondition and for the postcondition. Now for the test driver. I've set up a loop with 1,000 iterations, and we generate random numbers in the range of 0 to 9999.999. So random dot, this is the random.random function, which returns a value between 0 and 1. This is a floating point number, and it comes from the random module. And then we feed this random number into a square root function, storing the result in z. Note that we don't need any assertions down here because the assertions up here already take care of everything. When all tests are successful, we print out done. So this is our test, and the question is, what's going to happen? Is it that the program terminates gracefully, outputs done, all tests are passed? Is it that the square root precondition fails? Is it that the square root postcondition fails? Or, thinking of Python, do we see something completely different? Over to you.